Hi, my name is Paul Everett. No, no, it's not. Hi, my name is Helen Scott, and I am standing in for Paul Everett just this once. This is your WebStorm What's New in 2023.2 video, and I have got lots in store for you. We are going to look at pretty TypeScript and JavaScript errors, CSS nesting, language support for both Volar for Vue and Svelte. The new UI is finally here. Single line git commits. Plus lots more. Let's get going. First up, prettier errors for both TypeScript and some JavaScript. Let's start with TypeScript because it's more exciting. Here's an error rendered in the previous version of WebStorm. And here's the same error in this version of WebStorm. And this implementation works for any language, so not just English. Let's try Korean. We've also implemented this for some JavaScript errors as well. So check out this error in the previous version of WebStorm. And here's the same error rendered in this version of WebStorm. Note that the color in the error matches your editor, which can help you to parse the message. On to CSS nesting. WebStorm now lets you nest your CSS rules inside one another. Here's some CSS before nesting in WebStorm. And here's that same CSS, but written in a nested way. Which style you use is up to you. We've introduced support for Volar, the Vue Language Server. This is going to give you type checking for both your Vue and TypeScript files. For example, on line 104, WebStorm is detecting an error for type, which is coming from the Vue Language Server because we're using TypeScript 5 or higher. WebStorm now provides completion for the inject field, resolves the injected property, and shows usages for methods defined for the provide option. Support for define model is also available. Sticking with language servers, WebStorm will now use Svelte by default for your, well, Svelte projects. Svelte support gives you null checks inside your markup, quick documentation, quick navigation, and more. It's in early development and we're still ironing out some bugs, so please do share your feedback with us. There's going to be a ticket in the description if you'd like to do so. As I'm sure you've noticed, I'm using the new UI for this video. Let's take a quick look around. Your main toolbar is where you'll find project information, including the name, version control status, and a redesigned run widget. The toolbar icons have had a facelift as well, so if you're not sure what the name is, you can hover over it. You can also rearrange them however you want. I'm using dark mode here, but if you want to switch to a light theme with a light toolbar, you can do so. Finally, you can change the color of the main toolbar for each project, which is helpful if you've got multiple projects open and you want a quick visual reminder as you switch between them. Did you know that you can now select individual lines to include or exclude from a multi-line commit? In the diff view, just select which lines you want to include or exclude on a case-by-case basis. You can do this using the right-click context menu or by selecting the checkboxes. You might choose to do this if some commits belong to different tasks, for example. And there's more! Live templates for React hooks. Easy button for watch mode for jest tests. Review GitLab merge requests within your IDE. And finally, an LSP API for all you plugin writers out there. To see all the features in this release, check out the blog post, which will be in the description. Let us know, as always, what you think. What feature are you most excited about? Share your feedback with us. Well, share it with the WebStorm team, because I'm out of here. Finally, thank you for watching. Thank you for spending your precious time in WebStorm. We appreciate you.